So get up, unite for your team. Give the best we've got. Yes, how we
every man, every man, every bitch, every man, every deal, every wicked, every soul. And the art and soul and passion, and the culture, Caribbean glows. When flame come out all nation, to the team in a unification. When the stadium ram beat at the grandstand, and the meaning of unification.
It's how we play.
Evening, everyone, and welcome into Warner. That's right, we're back here in one of the idyllic stadiums in this part of the world, St. Kitts and Nevis, the Patriots hosting the Jamaica Tallawahs match 7 of season 7 here in 2019 in this gorgeous part of the planet. And we're going to be everywhere around the Caribbean, Jamaica, St. Kitts and Nevis, St. Lucia, partying in Barbados. We've already been to Trinidad and Tobago and Guyana, and can't wait for the rest of this week. A little bit earlier, the 10-crit coin toss with Darren Gang and the two captains, and it went the way of Carlos Brathwaite. He said, look, gents, we will go as a team and field first. First home game for SKP. Very experienced side. Unchanged, I can tell you, from their earlier match there against TKR. And, Rodman Pohl, he is captaining the side tonight. Just to give Chris a break and perhaps the transition into the future with Christopher Henry Gale turning 40 later this month. And now there's been some changes here. Shamar Brooks comes in with Laurie Evans and Dominic Drakes. They're in. Hafiz Cottrell and Otley are out. Tiny boundaries, as we know. A little bit bigger square, very tiny straight. And if the breeze is in, then you can have a spot of bother. But he's underway straight away as the big guy. Gale. Forfa. Here it comes, Tom Moody. Get out there and catch it. Here's our first hero, maximum of the evening. Someone get out of the air hostess and tell her it's left the building. Gee, back to back from Gale. And that's a treat there from Glenn Phillips. Talk about a scissors contract. Gone. They needed this. Captain Carlos takes a very simple catch. It's the end of Phillips.
Yeah, opting for a full delivery again on Zari Joseph. We've seen him try the short ball previously, but this time much fuller to Glenn Phillips. And on this occasion, just spooning a simple catch to Carlos Brathwaite at mid-off. And it's the first wicket for the home team, and getting an El Dorado celebration in as well. Zari Joseph, Glenn Phillips has to depart for 8. 37 for 1 to Jamaica Tallawahs.
Tries it short. Protection won't get there. Got too much of it. A good piece of this one.
Beautiful. Absolutely beautiful from Chadwick Walton. He's been bogged down. He releases the pressure with that hero maximum. Nice clean shot. The power of Chadwick Walton, as if he was taking a couple of deliveries to get into stride. My word, that was powerful. Full. And it goes all the way. Straight boundaries, very short. Chadwick Walton makes really good use of them.
Ah, oh, Samuel might get interrupted again. This has gone in a similar fashion and direction. 100 up now, courtesy of Gale with another maximum. For the JTs, this will go all the way. What a cracker. 50 for Chadwick the Rope Walton. That is brilliant. What a stunner. 116 for one after a dozen. Well played. Brathwaite's disappeared. Talk about Fat City here in St. Kitts. There's another half century. Courtesy for Gale, 53 from 36 here. and goodbye. New balls, please. We've got 100 partnership up to between these two. Boom! He hurts your moods in a hurry, the big guy. 150 up now, 155 for one. All the way, just about. In such confident mood here.
Linked. Doesn't have the distance, yes. Just over the head of Riyad Emirate there in that long off position.
And again.
Well, it's like deja vu. Raining sixes here at Warner Park, courtesy the big man, Christopher Henry Gale. Paul is two. And he will get it, he will get it. Well, I'm not quite sure. Umpire Basarat goes upstairs just to check and confirm if the second run was completed. The Patriots, they think they have this one.
An excellent bit of feeling on the old field from Shamar Brooks. An excellent throw as well. A direct hit, always dangerous. Chris Gill waits to find out whether or not he did in fact get that 100.
And it's not out, that's a century. Take a bow, Christopher Henry Gale. Yeah, he's in all smiles. The first century in Hero CPL 2019 goes to the man of the moment. It's an El Dorado celebration as well. One that we've come to know from the big man, Christopher Henry Gale. Goes high. Will this be taken? A man gets under it and takes the catch. It's a Republic Bank classic catch.
Carlos Brathwaite calling the catch, taking the responsibility. Never easy when they go so high into the night sky. He had composure, he got into position early, took responsibility and pounced it. The end of an excellent partnership and a very, very good innings from Chadwick Walton. He goes for 73. It's 199 for two.
Struck firmly. Andrew Russell had to take evasive action. He's flawed. Still has a smile on his face, but 14 runs from the over. Another expensive one. It's 213 for two.
This one has been smacked by Andrew Russell over wide. Almost a catch in the crowd there as well. Another hero maximum.
Yeah, good length. Good straight up in the air. It was wide as well. We've been talking about that length and line. First delivery up. Gets the prize wicket of the big man, the century maker, Christopher Henry Gale.
Very, very shrewd captaincy. We're having a bit of a laugh here at the expense of Sammy, but Fabian Allen just bowling that into the wicket as quickly as he possibly could. And Gale looking to hit a home run and just coming off the toe of the bat. What an innings. What a superb innings. We've seen it so many times from this man. He continues to entertain and set the Hero CPL alight. Goes off to a big applause from the locals here. Chris Gale, 116. Just off the 62, it's 228 for three.
That's gone all the way. Has the distance, yeah. The umpire's hands will go up in the air. Confirmation, it's another hero maximum. Goes way up into the sky. Fielder gets under it. Should be taken, yeah. Another wicket for Fabian Allen, a little too late at this time.
Into the pitch once more from Fabian Allen. Good pace, hustling Andrew Russell, so he didn't have enough time to swivel on this delivery. only managing to get it high into the night sky. And Carlos Brandt with very safe pair of hands, taking another catch in the outfield. And that's the end of Andre Russell. He goes for 15, 234 for four.
Goes high, goes long, and they will end with a hero maximum at six to that total. It's 241, the Tallawahs close on.
A really good effort from the JTs here in Warner Park. The highest score in CPL history, surpassing 226 by St. Lucia, 241 for four. That must be a pleasing effort, and we are seeing the smiles on the faces of the Jamaica Tallawah players. Boy, aren't they happy, aren't they ecstatic, supporting the crowd as well for this Jamaican team. Carlos Brathwaite would be disappointed with the effort from the bowlers. I thought that they didn't seem to have a clear plan. Maybe the execution was a bit off. Disappointment certainly for the home team. Their first game here in Warner Park in the home leg. Chris Gayle leading the way, 116 off 62. Well supported by Chadwick Walton. Excellent partnership between those two, 73 for him. Andre Russell, 15 off 8. And Springer, one ball, six runs. 241 for four.
Well, the bowling's not going to read too well. Unfortunately, Fabian Allen ended up with two, but that was right at the back end. 15 and over for him. Emirate was used up early along with Brathwaite to try to stem the flow of that onslaught in the middle of the innings. Vasper Drakes, I thought, not Vasper, his son, I should say, bowled exceptionally well, I thought, but was a little unlucky at the back end.
Warner Parker has seen some really fantastic performances. The Patriots, they will need 242, just about 12.1 runs for over.
It's how we play.
What a shot, brilliantly played. Just back of a length, just got into position nicely and picked it off in front of square.
Yeah.
Right on cue, Louis. Pops it. Sixer.
He doesn't bother moving because he doesn't have to. This has disappeared as well. On the charge, Evan Lewis. Moods! Look out, Moods! That is Moods!
Here on Maxim! Extraordinary! Of Thomas.
That is a classic cricket stroke. Just fetch it as it goes into the boundary hoardings.
This is not a bad delivery. It's a good shot. Sometimes you have to take that on your chin as a bowler. Just carving this one.
No! You're kidding me! No! You can't do that! Sunshine Snacks power shot of the night again! Finishes 5 at 75 for none.
Russell goes into the stand. Welcome, Andre Russell. This is Evan Lewis at his very best. Hero maximum. And he goes for it. And should get it as well. Hats off to Evan Lewis. What a knock it has been. Breaks the record for the fastest CPL 50.
Oh, you little ripper. Talk about a party. It's the biggest in sport. We're going to cut loose some more here before the night's out.
was there an edge? Yeah. Anticlimactic. Look at the celebration, Andrew Russell. He is a big match player. Gets the edge. Lewis has to depart.
Seems to be a slower delivery from Andrew Russell. Just changing up the pace a bit. Catching Evan Lewis off guard. Faint little nick through to the wicketkeeper, Glenn Phillips. But what an entertaining innings comes to an end from Evan Lewis. Really good platform, really good start. 53 of 18, 85 for one.
Starts with a boundary. This is really good. Maintaining the tempo of the innings so far for the Patriots. There she goes. Buckle up. That's a big strike from Laurie Evans.
Loving a lick from Laurie.
Too short. Just as I complimented him, he went short and paid the price. Hero maximum. Last ball before the halfway stage. And it ends with a hero maximum. Absolutely smoked. 133 for one. Should be taken. No, good effort in the end. Good effort. Surely saved his team a couple runs, but what it does, brings a half century yet again to Devon Thomas. Consistency being shown by the wicketkeeper batsman for the Patriots.
This one's gonna be a stinker.
Will it be taken? Yeah, Andrew Russell doesn't drop many. Takes it comfortably in the end. It's a Republic Bank classic catch. 161 for two.
Good delivery here from Ocean Thomas. Just checking this one, Laurie Evans. Andrew Russell, he doesn't make any mistake in the outfield. And after a good and entertaining knock from Evans, he has to depart for 41 of only 20 deliveries. 161 for two, the Patriots.
Oh, this is hit way over mid-off. It's not hit out of the middle of the bat, but it's enough for a couple of bounces for four. It's... Oh, can you believe it? What a stunning catch! Republic Bank classic catch if I've ever seen one.
This is a spectacular catch from Glenn Phillips behind the stumps. Excellent game-changing moment, possibly. End of Devon Thomas, who's played an excellent hand. Trying to go over mid-wicket, getting a thick outside edge, and what an effort from Glenn Phillips. Devon Thomas goes. 176 for three.
Hit firmly and picked out cover. Oh, yes, he has. He's picked him out. The first ball that's pitched full. Brathwaite slashes it straight down cover's throat.
And the second wicket in the over for Ocean Thomas. This time, the captain of the St. Kitts and Nevis Patriots trying to go over extra cover. Not enough connection, finding that man for another Republic Bank classic catch, Andrew Russell. 176 for four, Brathwaite goes for a dunk.
Glove down the leg side, and yes it is! That's number three in the over. Phillips takes another one.
And that's an excellent over here from Ocean Thomas. Another short delivery. This time Jason Mohammed trying to pull this one. Just managing to get some glove, perhaps some bat on that. And a simpler catch, a much simpler catch for Glenn Phillips. Jason Mohammed goes for a duck.
And he gets all of this, baby! This has been fatted monster! Holy heck!
Oh, that is sweet. That is so clean and so straight. Here's another one. This is the 18th, and it is disappearing. Why? Then you've got to reload, and the next one goes for four. Jamaica franchise! There it is! Key moment at the death stages of match seven.
Off-pace delivery from Russell. Right on the stumps, right on target. Absolute shock all around the ground. Running the fingers across the seam. Brooks looking to swipe it through the leg side for another boundary. You could argue all he needed was a one or a two. 27 though, off 15. It's 2-2-7 for six.
Up, 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 and boom! It has gone all the way. What pressure. Valve released here. Don't they love it here in the party stand?
It's equal to the world record for the most sixes in a T20 match.
Oh, take my breath away with this one. Smoking it behind point. Brilliant. And there we go with the top edge. Racing away. That's it. Is it? Is it about? I think it is. Alambrado's celebration and partying. We've gone crazy up here in the box as well. What a victory.
It's the second highest successful run chase in T20 cricket. This was a brilliant effort on the part of the Patriots. Faced with a mammoth target score of 242. You just felt that the Tallawahs started at the halfway stage with the advantage. But it was not to be. Evan Lewis, Devon Thomas, putting a damper on that innings by Chris Gayle.
Well, you don't win any match in the first half. And the Patriots have shown that even though they went missing in the field and with the ball, they came to the party with the bat. Always difficult to defend a small ground on a good wicket. That's why Carlos Brathwaite at the toss elected to field first, because he knew it's always going to be a challenge to field second. Been a remarkable effort here. Fabian Allum finishing the job, but there's been many contributions from the Patriots throughout this to chase down an enormous total of 242.
The Patriots at home desperately wanted a win here against a tough side in Jamaica Tallawahs, with Chris Gayle back home with Chadwick Walton wanting to chase down 242. They have done it as a team collective. Thomas 71 from 40, Lewis 53 from 18, the fastest half century in the history of CPL. And then you throw in Laurie Evans, 41 from 20, 37-0 from 15, Fabian Allen take a bow, and 27 from Young Brooks off just 15. They got home in a canter.
And the bowling, well, the two bowlers amongst the wickets, four wickets to Shane Thomas, two to Andrew Russell, but everyone was very expensive, over tens. They never seem to be able to contain this Patriots batting. Their top four really putting the pressure on this bowling lineup, and they couldn't quite secure a win in the end.
241 and a simply outstanding performance from Gayle and Walton. And you think of that, they're only four down. Could have been more, but I tell you what, you thought it was probably going to be enough, given that the fielding needed to be sharp. The Patriots said, we were more passionate here tonight. And in Thomas, Lewis, Evans and Allen, they were simply good enough in match seven, in season seven, by four wickets and seven balls remaining.
Yeah, 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 yeah. Wave your hand, wave your hand, from the Caribbean. Put a wave on your hand, hey.
This is how we play the game.
This is how we play.
And we gon' represent and show them who we stand for.
Let's talk. match every part, every deal, every wicket, every stroke. And the heart and soul and passion, and the culture, Caribbean blood. When people come out all nation, to the team in a unification. When the stadium from beach at the grandstand, and the meaning of beautification.
It's how we play.
Yeah, yeah.
So give